Hey, your friend Michael Unks here. You may be wondering, is this photo of me photoshopped? Honestly, we have more important things to discuss. It's more important that we talk about raising your serotonin levels, because if they're low, you're likely to be irritable, anxious, perceive the world as unfriendly. You may feel depressed, pessimistic, have irregular sleep and appetite. But no need to worry, I'm a pharmacist, I've studied serotonin a lot, and in this video, we'll discuss 7 ways to raise your serotonin without taking medication and without taking supplements. Let's discuss 7 ways to raise your serotonin so you feel less like this guy and more like this guy. In order for us to make more serotonin in our brains and bodies, it comes from 2 precursors. The first one being tryptophan, and the second one being 5-hydroxytryptophan. Did tryptophan ring a bell for you? Did you think of turkey? Turkey makes you sleepy, right? Because of the tryptophan? Well, after doing a little research, I found that that is not the case. There is tryptophan in turkey, but there's also tryptophan in chicken. In fact, there's more tryptophan in chicken than turkey. But do you get exhausted after eating a chicken sandwich? I think not. I tell you this to possibly save you money. Yes, if you increase your tryptophan and increase your 5-HTP, which you can get in supplements, you can ultimately have more serotonin, but there is one caveat. These amino acids have to get through the blood-brain barrier. And all the blood-brain barrier does is protects the brain from foreign substances in the blood that could injure the brain. And this is a perfect segue to go into the first way, which is eating carbohydrates with a low glycemic index. Example of these carbs include oatmeal, brown rice, and wheat bread. Let's say you ate this piece of chicken. It has tryptophan in it, but it also has many other amino acids. Let's pretend all these different amino acids represent people at a dance party. All these amino acids that you ate from this chicken is hanging out in your stomach waiting to be digested. Not all these amino acids go through your brain. Tryptophan and 5-HTP do, but in order for that to happen, to go through the blood-brain barrier, we have to clear the room. And these low glycemic index carbohydrates do this through insulin. Insulin is the key that opens all the doors. It's stimulated when there's sugar in your blood. Insulin stimulated and all the doors throughout your muscles open up. The sugar can go in there and all those other amino acids go in there as well. It clears the room. And by doing so, by eating those carbohydrates that are low glycemic index carbohydrates, now you give yourself the chance to absorb tryptophan and 5-HTP and ultimately turn it into serotonin. But those low glycemic index carbs are crucial. I do want to point out that all sugar can stimulate insulin and open these doors, even the ones that are tasty and the ones you share on social media accounts. But they open the doors for a short period of time. We're shooting for long-term happiness, long-term increases in your serotonin. And these low glycemic index carbs do just that. The second way to raise your serotonin, sunlight. UV light from the sun's rays gets absorbed through your skin, which increases vitamin D production, which ultimately increases serotonin production. It depends on your skin tone, but as little as 30 minutes a day can do it. So join us in putting our bikinis on and getting some sun. Way number 3, get a massage. But be careful who you get it from. A strange guy in the pool is probably not the best person to get a massage from. I have evidence to back this up. There was a study done in pregnant women, and these subjects were massaged for twice a week for up to 4 months. And they found at the end of the study that their serotonin increased 30%. So treat yourself and get a massage today, just not from this guy. Way number 4, meditation. Not only will meditation increase your serotonin, it can help you make a tough decision. Here's a personal example. I had a date recently with a woman that was a little bit older than me. I had a big problem. I didn't know what to wear. Red V-neck or blue V-neck? It was only after meditation that I came up with the answer. I went with the blue, and my date was a huge fan. Way number 5, remember happy events. It doesn't matter what you're thinking about, as long as it puts a smile on your face. When you're remembering happy events, there's increased serotonin production in the anterior cingulate cortex. It's a region just behind the prefrontal cortex that controls attention. Having trouble recalling happy events? There's a quick fix there. Just ask your friends and family members. Then from there, start adding them to your journal. And whenever you have those tough times and you can't recall a happy event, look at your journal. Or you can store them in your phone. The 6th way to raise your serotonin, get better quality of sleep. This cat photo is adorable, don't you think? I mean, I'm a dog person and I love it. Research has shown about 7.5 hours sleep per night is ideal for most. What may work best for you, I know it's been working for me, is to go to bed at the same time each night and get up at the same time each morning. This is recommended because we operate on a 24-hour clock, a circadian rhythm. Going back to our chart, you notice that melatonin is at the bottom. Melatonin is a hormone that triggers your sleep cycle. Make sure right before bed to avoid bright light, avoid eating a big meal, and this should go without saying, but remove the Granny Smith apples from your bed. The seventh way to raise your serotonin is to exercise. The evidence is clear. Exercise increases tryptophan, which in turn increases serotonin. And what's amazing is something as simple as walking for 10 to 15 minutes can cause this spike in serotonin and have it last hours after exercise. Let's summarize the seven ways to raise serotonin real quick, and then let's answer the big question. Is this picture of me real, or is it photoshopped? Number one, eat low glycemic index carbs like oatmeal, brown rice, and whole wheat bread so that insulin can open all the doors, clear the room, and have the precursors to serotonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP enter the blood-brain barrier. Number two, get some sunlight about 30 minutes per day. My apologies once again, please forgive me. Number three, get a massage, just be careful who gives it to you. Number four, meditate, not only to raise your serotonin, but to help you make a tough decision, like deciding which V-neck to wear for your special date. Number five, recall happy events, and if you're struggling to remember, ask your friends, and then journal them or store them in your phone. Number six, getting better quality sleep, shooting for about 7.5 hours per night, going to bed at the same time each night, getting up at the same time each morning, knowing that we operate on a circadian rhythm. And lastly, number seven, exercise. You may not look like a fitness model right away, but you will feel good right away, and it will last hours after exercise. Now it's time for the truth. Is this photo of me real or photoshopped? This is going to blow your mind, but this photo is photoshopped. Here's the original picture. This is your wannabe bodybuilder friend Michael Unks inspiring you to learn, laugh, and love. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. And if you want to reach your potential, and if you want to learn and laugh at the same time, I make weekly videos. Remember to subscribe.